Another type of limit problem we'll want to evaluate will be the limit of piecewise functions. So a piecewise function is a function that has different definitions on different domains or different values of x. For problems like these, we'll need to investigate both the right and left-hand limits and then see what that tells us about the existence of the limit. So for the limit of the function itself to exist, keep in mind we need those one-sided limits to be equal. So for a function like we have in example 5, f of x is defined to be 2x plus 3. When x is something less than 5, when x is greater than 5, the function is defined as negative x plus 12. So what we need to consider is the limit as x approaches 5 from the left-hand side. So that means we're starting at negative infinity, working our way up to 5. So we're considering values of x that are something less than 5. So the limit as x approaches 5 from the left of f of x is the limit of 2x plus 3. This is a polynomial function, so we can use direct substitution to get 2 times 5, which will be 10, plus 3, or 13, as our limit. To consider the limit as x approaches 5 from the right means we're considering values larger than 5, so we use the second half of that definition for our function. So this will be taking the limit as x approaches 5 from the right-hand side of negative x plus 12. Again, a polynomial function, so we can plug in 5 to get negative 5 plus 12 gives us a limit of 7. So in this case, we would say that the limit for this function as x approaches 5 does not exist. And again, this comes back to that idea of the theorem for our one-sided limits. Since the left and right-hand limits are not equal to each other, then the limit as x approaches 5 does not exist. So if we had come up with equal values here, we would say that the limit does exist, and it would be the same as those two numbers. The other question we're asked doesn't have anything to do with limits, just wants us to evaluate the function at a value of 5. And in this case, we would say that that's undefined, because each of these are strict inequalities. So our function's only defined when x is less than 5 or greater than 5. So at 5 itself, it's undefined unless we made one of these a greater than or equal to, a less than or equal to. But since that's not there, our function is simply undefined at x equals 5.